Hello guys, welcome to my today class. In this class, I'm going to discuss the last topic of module 2. It's nothing but Lagrange's undetermined multipliers. The Lagrange's undetermined multipliers is also we are finding maximum minimum for function of more than one variable. The difference between what we discussed in the previous class, finding a maximum minimum for function of two variables, and also the Lagrange's undetermined multipliers is, in the previous class, what we discussed to find out the maximum minima for function of two variables, we don't have any conditions, means constraint. Directly we have to find out extremities. We already discussed how to find out the extremities of the given function involving more than one variables. Usually we are considered two variables. In the Lagrange's undetermined multipliers, one of the method to find out maximize or minimize of the function subject to the constraint. Constraint means they given some conditions. Say, find the maximum value of x square plus y square plus z square subject to the condition x plus y plus z is equal to 3a, like that. Whenever they provide constraint or condition, in such cases, we are going to use Lagrange's undetermined multipliers, easy to find out maximize value or minimize value of the given function. That now we are going to discuss for Lagrange's undetermined multipliers. This is a difference between finding a maximum minima for function of two variables and Lagrange's undetermined multipliers. Still have a doubt, I think, in your mind. Madam, they suppose f is a function of three variables. They are given a function in terms of, say, x square plus y square plus z square, subject to the condition x plus y plus z is equal to 3a. Now, it's possible to make it to function of two variables. How? First, I have to express z in terms of x and y, 3a minus x minus y. Then you substitute here. What we get, f is only a function of two variables are nothing but what actually? X square plus y square plus what is my z? 3a minus x minus y whole square. Then you know how to find out maximum minima function of two variables. In some cases is okay. Some cases, once you express is the function is involving two variables, you don't get it a simple function. Whenever having a simple function, then easy to find out the partial derivative of first order and also second order. Then once we get a complicated function, it's not easy to find out the partial derivative. Once you find out partial derivative, finding a critical points is not easy. Instead of, if you want to overcome this difficulty, there we are going to use Lagrange's undetermined multipliers. Is it clear? I think even though the given condition is possible to convert some cases in function of two variables, but suppose we get a complicated function, it's not easy to proceed. It's not easy to find out critical points. If you want to overcome, there we are going to use Lagrange's undetermined multipliers. Okay. Now, for example, design the dimension of the box to minimize its volume subject to the certain fixed amount of building materials. Here I am taking casts, take some other material also. There also we are using the Lagrange's undetermined multipliers. Minimize the area of a field subject to 500 feet of fencing material. Now here I am taking building and field and also return the area x and y. Maximize, what's my area? Maximize the area of the field subject to 500 feet of fencing material. Okay, this is a figure what I have written here. Now maximize the area is nothing but what? X into y. Correct? Now what's the area of this building is x into y. Constraint, subject to the condition. What's the condition? X plus 2y must be equal to 500. They're given minimize field subject to 500 feet of fencing material. Therefore, what's the condition? What's the constraint or condition I return? X plus 2y is equal to 500. Yes? Now, in that case, whenever they're given, they provide, I want to find out maximize and minimize is a function of more than one variable. Not only two variable, may having a three variable, four variable, five variable, along with the conditions, there how to find out maximum minima for function of involving more than one variable and with along with the constraint or condition. It must be use the following working rule. Here also, first we have to write the auxiliary function. How to make it the auxiliary function? You take new function, say capital F of x, y, z, suppose involving three variables. Now, the given function, maximize what the function is given, that is my f of x, y, z, plus lambda. Lambda is a parameter into phi of x, y, z. While writing phi of x, y, z, observe the constraint or condition. Suppose they given the condition, say f of x plus y plus z is equal to a. Before going to take phi of x by z, you make it right hand side is 0. Means shifted that whatever term you have in the left hand side, make it to 0. After that, what we get that terms, that is nothing but my phi of x by z. This is a way I have to frame a auxiliary function based on the given function corresponding constraint. Okay. Now, after once you frame that auxiliary function, as usual, find out the first order partial derivative. Here, they are having three variables with respect to x, with respect to y, and with respect to z. And then equal to 0 because I want to find out the critical point. And then, once equal to 0, after equal to 0, just imagine each and every equation definitely have a lambda because we are framing an equation along with the lambda. Okay. Now you find out from each of the equation the value of lambda in terms of x, y, z. Each of the values, suppose x is lambda is equal to x, y, simply I am going to take lambda is equal to y, z, lambda is equal to z, x. Then once you calculate the value of lambda from each of the equation and then equate, x, y is equal to lambda, lambda also must be equal to y, z, lambda also must be equal to z, x. And then from that, try to express there are three variables you have. There are two variables that express in terms of another remaining variables. Means, so now I'm trying to express y and z in terms of x or x and z in terms of y like that. The two variables I'm going to express in terms of remaining another one variable. Once you express it, and then you take the constraint. What's the constraint they're given? X plus y plus z is equal to a. In that constant, you substitute that because I express, just imagine, using this relation, I express y and z in terms of x, automatically from this constant, we get the value of x. Once we get the value of x, then automatically we get the remaining y and z. Okay? This is a way I have to find out the critical points. But keep in mind, the critical points, you get three components because having how many variables are considered independent variables are three. X1, Y1, Z1, X2, Y2, Z2, like that. Okay. Once you get the critical points, substitute in the given maximize or minimize function, means f of x, y, z. Observe carefully for which critical point we get minimum value, say that that's a minimum value. Which critical point we get a maximum value, say that that's a maximum value. This is a way I have to find out the maximum and minimum value. Now again I'm going to repeat these points. Observe carefully. First you write the auxiliary function, take new variable because already involved f, therefore in the given problem f of x comma y z. For example, just few minutes before I show that this one. I'm explaining based on what you have, just now I explained. I've taken one simple example here. Maximize the area of a field subject to 500 feet fencing of the material. What's the problem here? The problem for this maximize, okay? Maximize what actually area, A is equal to what actually? X into Y. If you want to take area, is nothing but F of X, Y is equal to X into Y, okay? Subject to the constraint, what's the condition they're given? X plus 2y is equal to 500. Now, I want to maximize the area. Therefore, first you have to write the auxiliary function. What is my auxiliary function involving two variables? You don't take same small f, you take it at other variable, say letter, say capital F, whatever may be, or y, whatever may be, I have to take. Capital F of x comma y is nothing but small f of x y plus lambda into the constraint. I told how to take the phi of x comma y. Okay. What is my f of x y? X into y. What is my phi of x y? What is my phi of x y? I told very clearly. Before going to take phi of x y, you shifted all the terms in the right hand side. left hand side, sorry, make it right hand side must be 0. What are the terms we get in the left hand side? That is nothing but phi of x, but x plus 2y minus phi 1, right? This is capital F of x, y. Okay. Now I have to find out with partially with respect to x is nothing but y plus lambda. With respect to x, what's a constant? Y is constant. Okay. Then y into derivative of x with respect to x is 1, lambda into 1. Similarly, I have to find out partial derivative with respect to y. With respect to y, we get x plus lambda into 2 because 0, 2. Okay. Then after that, what we are going to do? Equate to 0. I am explaining how to apply Lagrange's undetermined multipliers to find out the solution of the problem. Okay, fine. Now here, after equating the result, I told you try to find out the value of lambda. From the first equation, what is lambda? Minus y. For the second equation, what is lambda? Is minus x by 2. Therefore, minus y is equal to lambda. Lambda also must be equal to minus x by 2. We get this relation. This is a thing I told. Okay. Using this, try to express x in terms of y or y in terms of x. Okay. Now, that implies what is my x is 2y. Okay. X is equal to 2y. You take this constraint. What is my constraint? X plus 2y is equal to 500. Constraint or condition. Substitute x in terms of y. What is my x? 2y. 2y plus 2y, what we get? 4y equal to 500. What is my y? 500 by 4. Okay. Now what we get y is nothing but, if we want to simplify further, 4 ones are, then we get 10. Okay. Then 2s are, and then 5. Okay. Yeah. 125. Y is equal to 125. Okay. Y is equal to 125. What is my x? You know that what is my x is 2y. Now what we get actually, x is nothing but 125 into 2. Now what we get actually 250, right? Yeah. 250. Now these only we get one critical point. What is my critical point? We get x comma y is nothing but 250 comma y. Y is what actually? 125. Then at this point you find out what is my f of x y. What is f of x y? Is nothing but area. What is my area? X into y. What we get? 250 into 125. Give rise our maximum area of the given problem. Okay. This is a way I have to find out maximum and also minimum. Why I treated maximum? Because see, observe carefully, this definitely with this give rise maximum value because x is 250, y is what actually 125. But you already framed that equation. I'm showing that what's the equation we frame, that here. Maximize, okay, the framing equation is nothing but maximizing the area of a field subject to 500 feet of fencing material. What's a maximize? The area is nothing but x into y. The condition or constraint is nothing but x plus 2y is equal to 500. Yes. From this, now I explained how I to find out our maximized value for using Lagrange's undetermined multiplier. How to find out? First, you have to frame an auxiliary function. How to frame an auxiliary function? Small f of x, y, z is nothing but our area plus lambda into phi of x, y. It's not necessary to take z here. While taking f of x, y, phi of x, y, you shifted 500 in the left hand side, make it to right hand side 0. That is nothing but our phi of x, y. This is my auxiliary function. Differentiate partially with respect to x, with respect to y, and then equal to 0. Equal to 0, then we get the value of lambda. Then I told from each and every equation you find out the lambda of lambda and then equate it. Then you have to find out here having two variables, you express one of the variable in terms of other. Suppose having more than two variables, you express all other variables in terms of the one of the variable. Suppose you're having x, y, z, express y, z in terms of x, like that. Once you express it, substitute in the constraint condition equation, automatically we get the value of the critical points. We get this way I have to find out the critical points. Once you find out the critical points, you substitute in the which function I have to maximize or minimize. That gives us corresponding maximize value or minimize value. Here having only one critical point, then this is our maximize value. We can't expecting always we get only one critical points. Sometimes we get more than that. You find out for all the values for the function, what they are asking, the maximize and minimize, compare it for which critical point we get minimize, for which critical point we get maximize value, then we say that corresponding these are the maximum value and minimum value of the given function. Suppose the function having the corresponding function, they are having a constraint or condition. In such cases, this is the way we are going to do. I think it's clear how to apply Lagrange's undetermined multipliers. That's a thing, that's a point only I explained in my slide. First step, we have to write the auxiliary function. After that, where lambda is a parameter. After, you have to find out first order partial derivative. Here, they're having three variables with respect to x, with respect to z, and then equal to 0. From each and every equation, you try to find out the lambda. Once you find out the lambda, equate that, you try to express each of the, each of the variables. So, for example, here having three variables, say x, y, z. Once you're having three variables, in that case, try to express two variables in terms of other, like that. Means try to express every variable in terms of single variable commonly. Once you express that using from each of the equation, you are finding a lambda, no? After equating the lambda, means then try to express every variable in terms of commonly one of the variable. Once you express it, and then we are substituting where in the constraint equation, we get the values of the critical points. Once we get critical points, you substitute in the small f of x by z. That small f of x by z only I have to maximize or minimize. Once you substitute that, then you have to find out what's the minimum value, what's the maximum value, what's the value I have to find out. You find out all from all the critical points what is my small f of x by z. You compare that, we get what's a maximum value, what's a minimum value. This way I have to find out maximum or minimum value of the given function. Suppose is involving more than one variable. It's not necessary only two, maybe having three or four, five, more than one variable. Along with that, they have a constraint. In such cases, we are going to use Lagrange's undetermined multipliers. Whenever they're having a two variables, it's possible I go for, see, observe carefully what I taken here. This is a one of the example what I explained. Even though they're having a two variables, it's not possible to go for maximum minimum for function of two variables. Yes, because they're having a constraint. See, this is a one of simple example. Okay, fine. They have a is I want to maximize area x into y subject to the condition x plus 2y is equal to 500. But you can't go for maximum minimum for function of two variables. Yeah, if you want to go for that, you can't neglect this. They're asking to find out the maximize the area based on this condition. Suppose you apply directly maximum minimum for function of two variables, it's failed to take a decision based on this condition, based on this constraint. If you want to overcome, there we are going to use Lagrange's undetermined multipliers. Therefore, even though they're having a two variables, that's why I have told generally, whenever the function involving more than one variables, they're having a conditions or constraints, how to proceed, how to take a maximize or minimize value of that, how to find out. Using Lagrange's undetermined multipliers, then easy to find out what is a maxima or minimum value of that. This is one of the examples. See, observe. You can't go for what we discussed in the previous class, maximum minimum for function of two variables. Now, for three variables, it's possible to express z in terms of x and y, just now I told. Even though I express, it's not easy to find out the critical points. Why I have to do like that? better I to go for Laplacians and determine multipliers? Easy to find out. What I put this is nothing but is author picture who is invented that Laplacians is invented this. That's a, that name is nothing but Laplacians and determine multipliers. Now I think it's clear how to do where they're going to use. Whenever they're having function involving more than one variables, I want to maximize, minimize along with a constraint or condition, there I'm going to use Laplacians and determine multipliers. How to find out? First you write the auxiliary function and then using constraint and function, and then you find out first order partial derivative equal to zero. While framing an auxiliary function, you are using a parameter, you find out that value of lambda for after equating 0 for fx and fy fz is 0. Once you framing a lambda, using that value of lambda, try to express each and every variable in terms of commonly one of the variable. You substitute these condition, this condition where in the constraint or condition, automatically we get critical points. Once you get critical points, you substitute these critical points in the what function I have to maximize and minimize. Then compare it. Which for which point we get a maximum, which point we get a minimum, you write it. This is a way I have to find out. Thank you very much for listening my talk. This I'm come and meet in the next class. One more class I'm required. In the class I'm going to solve two problems: how to find out the maximum or minimum value using Laplacians and determine multipliers. Thank you very much. Bye. See you and take care.